Hi everyone, this is Nupur. My name is Nupur. I'm a children's book illustrator. And hello, hi Mariam. I'm good, thank you. Hi Shreya, how are you? Hello, hi everyone, hi. Hi Vibhuti. Hi, welcome to another live drawing session. Mariam is saying, I'm excited to draw a hot air balloon. Are you? I am also. I'm fine, thank you, Shreya. Okay, so I'm trying to save some time by just directly showing you the artwork that we're going to do. So let's get started. Oops, sorry. Okay, so we, as you must have seen in the Instagram stories, that we are going to draw this hot air balloon. Okay, so hope you have your art supplies ready. I have mine here. I have a selection of watercolor pencils that I'm going to use. I've already thought of my color palette. Okay, so we start with again thinking about the layout. So I'm going to draw this hot air balloon on the top half of the page because I want to show as if it is flying high. Okay, so I think I'm going to draw it over here. I'm leaving lots of space here. Hello. Okay, so we start with a circle. You can draw your circle by freehand, or you can use something like, I have this candle lying around, so I can use this as a stencil. So I'm putting it here and then I'm drawing a circle. Actually, I'm thinking that I should have some cutout stencils of simple shapes like circles and squares and rectangles and things cut up in cardboard that I can use in the lesson. Hello Lavanya, how are you? Right. Hi. Okay, so we've started drawing this hot air balloon. If you have joined now, and here's my candle that I used for drawing the circle. You can do the same. Okay, so this is the circle, and then I'm going to go down and draw a little rectangle here for the basket. So I'm going down and I'm going to draw a rectangle here. Just draw a freehand rectangle like this. So for the people who are joining for the first time, let me remind you that you must hold your pencil away from the tip, not too close to the tip, so that you can't put too much pressure on the paper, because I want you to draw really, really lightly as you can. So you can easily erase it if you want to, or you can correct it while drawing if you are drawing very lightly. I'm drawing quite dark lines so that you can see them clearly on the screen. I'm recording this on for YouTube as well. If you can't draw right now with me, you can watch the video and do it later. Okay, so I've drawn a rectangle and another narrow rectangle for the top of the basket. Okay, so this is done. And now I'm going to draw a straight line here, smaller than this basket, shorter than the basket. So there's a line, and now I'm going to merge this to the circle to create the shape of the hot air balloon. So I usually draw with small strokey lines like this, and I'm merging it with this circle. I'm doing the same on this side. Okay. Thank you for the hearts. Okay, so this is done. Now let's tie this balloon to the basket. Like this. And now let's have another rope to tie it more securely. Like this. And on the other side, like this. Okay. Now we are done with the basic shape of the hot air balloon and the basket. We've done everything. Now comes the decorating part. Hello. So for the people who are joining now, we are drawing this hot air balloon today. So this is done. Now we are going to start drawing the pattern. So to start the pattern, I'm going to draw a upward curve in the middle of the circle first. So this will be my guideline to understand the curve of the hot air balloon. So I think this is the middle on this side, and here I'll draw two dots, and then I'm going to draw an upward curvy line like this. So I start drawing from this end with my strokey lines, and a little bit from this end, so I know where I'm going, like this, and then I'm joining it. So this is my guideline. I think it can be a little more curvy. Okay, now looking at this line, I'm going to draw another one here at the top. All are going to be upward curves. Now another one here. And maybe another one. So this is your basic shape done. Now you can follow this you can follow these curvy lines and design your own pattern. I'm going to draw a zigzag pattern, but you can do whatever you want to. You can make a rainbow, or you can create more detailings here, like vintage hot air balloons or whatever you fancy. Okay, so mine is zigzag, so I want some more guidelines to make my drawing easier. So I'll find a center of this line. I think it's somewhere here, and then I'll find the center of the top here, and then I'm going to draw a straight line here. This will be my guideline to draw the zigzag pattern. And then, now you have to look carefully. I'm going to find center of all these lines. Center of this line is here, center of this line is here, this is here. It doesn't have to be accurate, but just find a center here. And this line could be here. And now I'm going to join them together. So this will automatically give me the depth, the dimensional look that I want to create. So this time, see the thing, the same process again. I'm finding the center of this line, this here, this center here, and then I'm going to join everything. If you don't feel like doing this, just draw freehand. You don't need to measure up and follow this process. Okay. So this is the skeleton.
Which design are you making? Oh yeah, I'm trying to make a similar design like this,
like I made here. So I'm going to draw V shapes here. So I start from this end, and I'm going to draw a V in this box, another V in this box, another one in this box, V shape in this box. So I'll do the same thing. A V shape here, V shape again, inverted V shape. Okay, like this. Okay. so this is the main pattern. Now I'm going to draw the outline quickly with my watercolor pencil, not my watercolor pencil, my permanent ink pen. It is 0.05 from Faber Castell. Okay, so I start from here. I have the pencil drawing so I can draw over it quickly. So after going over all the outlines with the permanent ink, I'm going to erase the pencil marks and then we will color it. Can we paint? Sure, you can paint. That'll be nice. You can use any medium that you have. You can even use crayons or if you are drawing it on a big sheet of paper, you can use oil pastel, and you can even use oil pastel to outline it and then color it with watercolor. So yeah, experiment with your medium and do whatever you like, and just try a different pattern, or maybe have a few hot air balloons at distance, like a small one here and even smaller here, to see, to show as if it's a whole field full of hot air balloons. Okay, so this is done. What else can I do? I'll just draw a straight line here. Just finish off with this line here. And yeah, that's enough, I think. And now I'll do the basket. The rest is going to be erased with my nice putty eraser. Oops. See, this eraser doesn't give any dust at all. It's very clean. But erasing it in one direction, and then your eraser is dirty, you just knead it like this, and now you have another clean surface. Okay, so I'll keep it aside. Now I'll start coloring. I'm going to use tonal colors like these together to create this effect. Okay, so I'll start with the top. I'm going to start coloring here with dark blue, and then I'll finish it off with light blue. Like this. And then the light green. I've also decided to do a little bit of collage. I'm going to do the clouds with this tissue paper that I have. I'm kind of addicted with adding a little bit of collage to my drawings, because I think it creates interest and texture. I'm loving it right now, so I just thought of adding the collage effect for the clouds. I'll show how I am going to do it. So I've just added two different colors, and then when I go over it with the brush, then blend even more nicely. So, this, the same thing, I'm going to use pink on the top and red at the bottom. Oh no, I've done it. I had to do it here. I did it on the wrong strip, but it's okay. I'm going to color it completely. So who all are actually drawing with me and who are just watching? Tell me who is drawing. Lavanya, are you drawing? Who else is drawing with me right now? You can write on the comment and say, I'm drawing. If you're drawing. Oh, you're drawing. Okay, great. Okay, so now I'll do the blue tonal thing here. Me and my mom are drawing, although I'm finding it a bit hard. Oh, are you finding it hard? What can we do? You can avoid this pattern and you can do simple rainbow if you want to. Actually, it is not hard, it is a bit complicated, I think a longer process, but maybe if you try it again later, you can watch on YouTube and try it once more and then you'll find it so easy and you will love this process because you can use the same process to fill in with pattern in any other thing. Today you've learned how to add pattern to a three-dimensional thing. You know, it's not flat. You're showing the spherical shape here. So if you try it once more, slowly, by pausing in between, then you might find it easy because it's not hard actually. Okay, so this is done. Now I'm going to color in the basket. For that I'm going to use my brown pencil and I'm just going to draw a checkup kind of, or just a grid sort of a pattern to make it look like a basket. Like this, and then maybe just vertical lines on the top. Okay, so this is done. Now let's do the water layer on it. So I've got clean water and a brush. Hello. Right, okay, I'm going to start with the... Okay, let's start with the pink color. I'm going to paint on the alternate bands so that each one gets a chance to dry slightly, if not completely. I'm using a small brush, it is I think number 3. Wetting it again and again as I feel the need to. Now I'm going to do the blue one so that the pink one gets a chance to dry. Otherwise it will bleed into the color next to it. I love watercolor pencils. I love it when it changes the shade when I put water on it. Okay, now I have to do the coloring here. but I'm trying not to touch the blue area so that it doesn't bleed. But if it does bleed, it's fine. Maybe I'll put it here so it is visible on YouTube and Instagram. Okay, I got the color here. My phone is already telling me that it's running out of battery. If it does pauses or something, I'll just keep on doing it for YouTube, and you can watch it later on YouTube. So I'm trying not to touch the next space, next band, to avoid the color bleeding. Now I'm doing the basket, so I'm trying not to rub the brush too much because I want to preserve the pattern that I've created. So this is done. Now I'm going to add the clouds. I'll just try to plug in my phone. I don't want it to lose this video. This is fine. Oops, a little wonky, but it's okay. At least it won't die away in the middle. Okay, now the fun bit. Now I'm going to add clouds with this paper. So what you can do is you can draw clouds on this tissue paper. It's hard to show on the screen. You can draw and you can cut up clouds without drawing them, or if you want to draw them with pencil. I'm going to double it up because I want a few clouds, or maybe I'll just make it triple. And then I'm going to cut this off. So I'm cutting off extra bits and then I'll add detail. So if you are cutting something, then my tip is to keep the hand that is holding the scissors steady and move the paper instead, or the material that you're cutting. Don't have a tissue paper, just color a sheet of paper blue and then just cut it up. So these are our clouds, and now I need glue stick. I have this glue stick. Let me think of the layout a little bit.
the one. So I want this hot air balloon to be flying really high. So what do you think I can do? Any guesses? I have to show the ground and ground very far off so I can show the height of the balloon. So I'm going to draw a little bit of field here to show the distance. So I'm going to draw just freehand rolling hills like this, and then maybe lines like this to show, make it look like a field, like a farming field, like this, and then maybe some small trees and stuff. Bushes here and there. So now it looks really high up, isn't it? And the branches and the tree trunks. So that's enough, I think. Now I'm going to color it up. I'm just going to go over the trees first a little bit. Just touch it with the tip of the brush, and now I'm cleaning the brush and dragging it on the side to remove extra water, and then just one stroke. Not too much, otherwise you lose the lines that you created. And then there we are. That's the judgment I think I'm going to do. Because these two colors are mixing with each other. Space. I'm going to give it a little bit of break here. I'm going to use white for then. This one. I'm shaping it. And just draw maybe these dots here. To separate these two bands. Alright, now I think it's looking quite balanced. So here is our hot air balloon. I hope you enjoyed drawing it with me, or if you're doing it later, then whichever the case is, please do send me your artwork. I love seeing your work. And if you want to see more draw along videos like this, then please do go onto my YouTube channel and draw. And do lots of practice and share your artwork with me. And if you like my YouTube channel, then subscribe it and like the video that you like. Have fun drawing and see you tomorrow. Same time. Bye.